you know what? I am a proponent of leadership, and I believe that there are leaders whose name has gone into the annals and history of Ghana, whose names have gone into the annals and history of the world. I'm a proponent of following Madiba, whom when you get to the United Nations in New York, you would find his bust over there. There are many people who would remember Ghana because of Dr. Kwame Nkrumah and for what he has done in wanting to form the OAU and now Africa Union and the things that he thought about and some of his own ideologies and thinking. One of my thoughts really are that leaders are successive and leaders must do more. And so when you put it in context that Dr. Kwame Nkrumah had an opportunity within which he had to establish his leadership opportunities that the Ghanaian people give to him. And post Kwame Nkrumah, other leaders have come from the First Republic to the Second Republic to the Third Republic and now the Fourth Republic. In this Fourth Republic, Jerry John Rawlings had an opportunity. John Ajekum Kufo had an opportunity, did excellent. Rawlings also did excellent during the times that they were given. John Evans Atta Mills had an opportunity. Dramani Mahama, John Dramani Mahama had an opportunity. Nanado Dankwa Akufo-Addo now has an opportunity. And so in proper comparison, you would expect that the current leaders would outdo what previous leaders have done. I mean, I think that is that in principle. And also to state that in the days of Ghana from 1957, the population was about 5 million people. You're talking 2024, and it's about 34 million people approximately. And so my position really is that when you are on political platforms, the energies are different, the rationales are different. You need to enhance and embellish the grassroots, get all of these people energized. And so let's not take the situation out of context. I mean, I think that for even as a new patriotic party, we adore Nkrumah, which is why President Nanado Dankwa Akufo-Addo set the Founders Day, which is August 4th, every single year. And we've been celebrating that. And I recall when Dr. J.B. Dankwa in 1947, August 4th, stated that Ghana was ready for independence. And independence was won by a collective of people, not just the big six, but a collective of people. So we adore the fathers of the land. And I don't want us to situate the conversations on a discredit of Dr. Kwame Nkrumah. We value the works of Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, the first president of the Republic of Ghana, the leader of government business during 1957 to 1960. We do appreciate those inputs that Dr. Kwame Nkrumah has made in Ghana. But you would expect that at least from Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, all leaders that have come have built upon the successes or otherwise of the previous leaders.
Okay.